So I got these from Skyline Specs. You know, every chance I get, I try to market them because I love their glasses. Oh, whoops, this side has the thing. You see the thing? The skyline. So I love that. And it's a local company and I like supporting local things. So they Instagrammed me and said, "Hey, we want to send you a complimentary pair." And so I got these. See how they look. Maybe they're better on mail. I'm not sure. I can't see because I have filming equipment in the way. But thank you, Skyline Specs. Here's their website. I'll link to it below as well. Thank you. Thank you. I'm super pumped that Mal's getting her scuba license. She's really pumped. They even have their own pool in here, which is which I like a lot. Like this place. We're in Dick's Sporting Goods. I need some new attire. I think I might need some shorts and some new Nike pants because I have like three pair, but they're not with me. They're in boxes in Hollywood. We'll grab that.
As your business grows, your schedule can become relentless. In my life, traveling, eating, drinking, and long hours at the computer, year after year, took its toll. It could sometimes be disheartening to look at photos of myself. However, luckily, I fashioned my business and my life to be one and the same. I'm able to make shifts. Success, in theory, is easy. Figure out who it is you want to be and map out a strategy to become that person. That's easy. Now you have to put in the work. In my life, I have no frivolous hobbies, no house, no car, no boats, four-wheelers, or major personal possessions of any kind. I have two pairs of pants and a handful of shirts. My temperament isn't suited for balance, so I don't try to find it. It's not always as easy as doing more than others are willing to do. Most of the time, you have to do more than people can even imagine doing. With that being said,
you better run.
Babe, that other one doesn't look cool. Yours looks cool. You look cool. Did it stick? No leaks? You look really cute. Yeah, you do. I like it. I like the pink too. It's really cute. Oh, yeah, I'll go snorkeling with you. Yeah, those will. There's no, unless you're gonna go many times a year, not many, but several times a year, just go with the cheap stuff. I've got a little more expensive stuff just because I've had it for 15 years or 20 years now, I guess, maybe 15. But you get the idea. Gotten some use. We just got out of Dick's Sporting Goods, and Mallory said, "I'm gonna start a competing store called Cox." That's how Mallory rolls. So I have the f-stop on 22 because I want the whole thing to be in focus. Skyline Specs, the skyline, the whole thing. And I think the angle's just about right. But I'm gonna do just a 1 second exposure on this one. I had it at 3.2 second exposure. So I like that shot. Zoom in for them. That looks pretty good. This one. And I'll show it on your end. So today I'm going to finish the vlog with something that I'm writing for my personal Facebook. So the other day a friend had posted this. On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the highest, what is your level of self-confidence? Now, I honestly assumed the responses would vary, but I saw mostly 10s, and the rest were 8 to 9s, and there was a 20. There were a couple that were more reasoned, and I'll get to that in a second. But here is my response. On any given day, it'll be at or near 0 at some point. Some days I'll have a 10 most of the day, but that's rare. Mostly it hovers around 5. Now that was completely honest. And I was honestly, I was a little bit perplexed at how people could live at a 10 every single day. But I wasn't that perplexed. I know people sort of put on a mask for Facebook. But I thought of the Charles Bukowski quote. The problem with the world is that intelligent people are full of doubts and the stupid ones are full of confidence. And so I clicked on the profiles of the people responding. And it represented that quote quite well. I mean, most of them either believed in fairies or spirit angels, or they would post links to, like, one had a link to a man who lived for 248 years old living on ginseng and rice wine. I mean, and they fully said we could all live like this if only we believed or something like that. I don't know what that says, but I found it interesting. And a few were hypnotherapists, and so perhaps they all have it right, and I don't. Or perhaps their goals are more in line with reality, where my goals, whenever I reach something, I tend to then put a new one way out here. And so if my goals maybe were a little more in line, I'd be self-confident about each of them. I don't know exactly what I think about it. But I thought I would put this out there and see what you all feel. What's your level of self-confidence? I know it varies during every single day, but fill me in on what you think. I'd like to feel it out.